हेलो स्टूडेंट, वी विल स्टार्ट द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन। कैपेसिटेशन एंड कॉन्टैक्ट। कैपेसिटेशन इन मैमल्स फ्रेशली इजैकुलेटेड स्पर्मेटोजोआ कैन नॉट फर्टिलाइज ओवा बिकॉज एक्रोसोम रिएक्शन डज नॉट ऑकर्स इन सच स्पर्म्स। The spermatozoa should remains in the female reproductive tract for about 7 hours in man, 6 hours in rabbit and 1 hour in mice before they can fertilize ova. During this time the coating substances, the so-called decapacitating factors on the sperm surface are gradually removed or deactivated. This phenomenon is called capacitation. As a result of capacitation, the receptor sites on the acrosome are exposed that enable the sperm to recognize the receptors present on the ovum surface. The mechanism of capacitation is unclear in man. However, the capacitation is triggered by calcium ions adhesion. The adhesion of spermatozoon to the egg surface occurs due to the presence of fertilizing molecules in the surface layer of egg cytoplasm, which receives anti-fertilization molecules present on the surface of spermatozoon. Fertilization and anti-fertilization reaction. Factors that mediate sperm egg interaction even before they make contact were identified in 1914 by F.R. Lilly, who proposed the first theory of the physiology of fertilization called fertilization theory. He observed that sea water surrounding unfertilized sea urchin eggs agglutinated the sperm and activated their motility. The reaction was specific, since some sperm from related species were unaffected. The factors called fertilized came from the egg jelly coat which slowly dissolved as egg stood in seawater. Lilly postulated that fertilizing was continuously secreted by the egg before fertilization, but it is now clear that fertilizing is the constituent of both jelly coats and egg membranes, such as vitelline membrane and plasma membrane. Grant in 1978. केमिकली अ फर्टिलाइजिन इज अ प्रोटीओग्लाइकैन फॉर स्पर्म टू द एग्लूटिनेटेड बाय फर्टिलाइजिन दे मस्ट हैव रिसेप्टर्स साइट्स ऑन देयर सरफेस दैट इज ऑन देयर प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन दीज रिसेप्टर साइट्स आर एंटी फर्टिलाइजिन इंट्रैक्ट विद द फर्टिलाइजिन मॉलिक्यूल्स द एंटी फर्टिलाइजिंस कैन बी एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द स्पर्मेटोजोआ बाय हीटिंग फ्रीजिंग और थोविंग और एसिडिफाइंग द वाटर बेलेंसकी इन 1981 has put forwarded the following two analogous mechanism regarding the mode of fertilization and anti-fertilization interaction. Number one, antigen-antibody type interaction. Antigen antibodies type interaction. The interaction between the sperm and the egg resembles an antigen antibody reaction. Fertilization in egg membrane may behave as an antibody combining with the antigenic site. That is anti-fertilizing on the sperm surface. In both cases, the bond between the two complementary substances is supposed to be depend on the spatial arrangement of the atoms in certain bands of the molecules in such a way that the shape of the surface of our molecules fits closely onto the surface of other the two bodies correspond each other as a template to the model. Next is key and lock type interaction. First is the antigen antibody type interaction and second is key and lock type interaction. Another often used analogy is the correspondence of key to a lock. Such an interaction is currently called adhesive recognition, which proposes that such an adhesion depends on bonding between complementary macromolecules, that is locks on one cell might fit keys on another. Trinkaus described in 1984. However, in case of this analogy, it may be relevant to remember that sometimes a lock may be opened by a wrong key. If it is adequately similar to the right one, such a situation can be observed in the cross reaction of fertilization and anti-fertilizing of very closely related species. Example, donkey and horse. Next is acrosomal reaction and penetration. Acrosomal. In the case of egg, with very thick and resistant envelopes found in insects and fishes, the sperm can penetrate the envelope only through a special canal, the micropyle or canals situated in the envelope. The ripe ova of nearly all animals groups except coelenterates remain surrounded by envelopes or follicles, cells, or both as in mammals. The spermatozoon has to penetrate through these barriers to reach the ovum. It is accomplished through the lytic enzymes containing in the acrosome. Lytic enzymes, secretion of lytic enzymes and containing in the acrosomes. It is accomplished through the lytic enzymes contained in the acrosome of the spermatozoon. These enzymes are commonly called as sperm lysins, colvin and colvin. In 1961, the sperm lysin dissolved the egg's envelope. Lysin enzymes dissolve the egg envelope locally and make the path clear for the spermatozoon. And that envelope dissolve. After that, the sperms easy to enter the egg. Spermatozoa to reach the surface of the ovum. The sperm lysin differs from one animal group to another. In mammals, the ova remain surrounded by the egg envelope, zona pellucida, which in turn remains surrounded by a layer of follicles, cells called corona radiata. The follicle cells are held together by a cementing substance called hyaluronic acid. The acrosomes of the mammalian sperms release hyaluronidase enzyme that dissolves the cement and enable the sperm to penetrate through the corona radiata. The activated spermatozoon on reaching the egg plasma membrane undergoes a number of changes in its acrosome region. All these changes are collectively described under the acrosome's reaction. The acrosome reaction commences when the sperm reach the zona pellucida. Zona pellucida is the believed to the contain species specific sperm receptors in the form of glycoproteins. These prevent interspecific fertilization in mammals. For examples, in mouse, zona pellucida containing three glycoproteins called ZP1, ZP2, ZP3, of which ZP3 is the sperm receptors. Mammalian sperms containing molecules in the plasma membrane that binds directly to the specific sperm receptors of zona pellucida, the sugar portion of the acts as the sperm receptor, and the protein portion is believed to trigger the acrosome reaction. When sperm binds to ZP3 in the zona pellucida, the ZP3 glycoprotein somehow affects the permeability of the sperm's plasma membrane, which allows sodium and calcium ions enter the sperm head and hydrogen ions to leave it. The increase in the concentration of free calcium ions induces acrosoma reaction. The acrosomal reaction is characterized by the rupturing of the membranes, plasma membrane and outer acrosomal membrane surrounding the acrosome ruptures the plasma and outer acrosomal membranes fuse together and vesiculate. It results in the gradual release of acrosomal contents, which contain several enzymes including the hyaluronidase and acrosin, a trypsin like protease enzymes, etc. Gradually the outer acrosomal membrane disappearing, and only the inner acrosomal membrane remains intact. Acrosin helps the sperm in penetrating the zona pellucida by digesting its material. Several sperms may attach to the zona pellucida, but once a sperm passes through it, the zona pellucida becomes impenetrable by other spermatozoa. This is known as the zona reaction. In this reaction, the structure of zona pellucida changes and lysosomal enzymes are released from the ovum that prevent other sperm from the attaching and penetrating the zona pellucida. Fusion of sperm and egg plasma membrane. The tip of the acrosomal tubules fuses with the plasma membrane of the egg, and a continuity between the cytoplasm of the egg and the sperm is established. In sea urchin, it involves the only 0.002% of the egg surface. In mammals, in the substance of acrosomal tubules, the spermatozoon appears to contact the egg surface by the lateral aspects. Following this action, the plasma membrane of the egg and the spermatozoon dissolve at the point of contact, and the nucleus and cytoplasmic components of the spermatozoon are drawn into the interior of the egg. Thus, a single cell called as zygote is formed. In organisms lacking an acrosome in their sperm, example telost fishes, there is no acrosome reaction in the where the sperm plasma membrane fuses directly with the plasma membrane of the क्रोमोसोम एक्टिवेशन ऑफ ओहम इन द एक्रोसोमल ट्यूबल्स ऑफ स्पर्मेटोजोआ कॉन्टैक्ट्स द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ एग इट ट्रिंगल ट्रिंगर्स अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ द इवेंट्स इन एग दीज आर डिस्क्राइब एज ए एक्टिवेशन ऑफ ओहम देर आर नंबर वन एन इंक्रीज इन द परमेबिलिटी ऑफ द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन टू सोडियम आयन्स कॉजेस द मेम्ब्रेन टू डीपोलराइज विद इन द फ्यू सेकंड सेकंड नंबर अ मैसिव रिलीज ऑफ कैल्शियम आयन्स फ्रॉम अ एन अननोन इंट्रासेल्युलर साइट कॉजेस अ मेक्ड इंक्रीज इन द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ कैल्शियम आयन्स इन द साइटोप्लाज्म विद इन 20 to 30 seconds एंड थर्ड इन एप्लुक्स एप्लुक्स ऑफ हाइड्रोजन आयन्स कपल टू अ इनफ्लुक्स ऑफ सोडियम बिगिन्स विद इन 60 seconds एंड कॉजेस द लार्ज इंक्रीज इन द इंट्रासेल्युलर पीएच दीज थ्री आयोनिक चेंजेस रिजल्ट इन इवेंट्स द कैन बी क्लासिफाइड अर्ली रिस्पॉन्स इट इंक्लूड्स द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ द पॉलीस्पर्मी दैट इज द एंट्री ऑफ फ्यूजन ऑफ मोर देन वन स्पर्म इन टू द ओहम इज प्रिवेंट प्रिवेंशन ऑफ पॉलीस्पर्मी ऑफर्स इन टू द एजेस ओके थैंक यू